Contrary to the statement of a former Philippine national security official, there's no such proposal by China to establish partnerships with Filipino fishing villages in the West Philippine Sea. That clarification from President Marcos Jr. following Clarita Carlos' statement on Friday. Carlos said the Philippine government is now studying Beijing's partnership proposal as part of efforts to achieve a modus vivendi in the contested waters. But Marcos insists Beijing has agreed not to prevent Filipino fisher folk from accessing marine resources in traditional fishing grounds.
Actually, I don't know how the word partnership was started to be used. It's really an agreement that China will not stop our fishermen from fishing. That's it. That's it. Very simple. We'll continue to allow our fishermen to fish in the fishing grounds that they have been to, they have used for many generations. That's it. It's that simple.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. hoping to score more investment opportunities for the country during his visit to Switzerland for the World Economic Forum. Is now in Davos along with First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos and his son Ilocos Norte Representative Sandro Marcos. Marcos believes the Maharlika Investment Fund will help make the Philippines an ideal investment destination.
Pare-pareho naman yung ginagawa natin dito sa mga trips. We talk about the Philippines, what the situation is as an investment destination. Now, that's added to that, meron na tayong pwedeng pag-usapan na sovereign wealth fund. So sasabihin ko, exactly what's happened that we are forming a sovereign wealth fund for investments for big investments in the basic areas such as agri, energy, digitalization, climate change, But the point being is that now there is a wealth fund.
Marcos is also expected to meet with several business leaders at the sidelines of the forum.
Climate activists protest in Davos, Switzerland ahead of this week's World Economic Forum. The protesters rallied against the role of major oil firms at the gathering and are demanding a climate tax on the rich. Big energy firms like Chevron and Saudi Aramco are among the business leaders joining the annual meeting in Davos.
We're demonstrating against the World Economic Forum, against the world global economy elite, because we're in an environmental crisis and also the economy is causing a lot of social problems.
Behind closed walls and doors, the rich and powerful are discussing and deciding upon our future. So yes, it's a disgrace.
President Marcos denies he ignored Kyiv's requests for him to have a phone call with his Ukrainian counterpart, Volodymyr Zelensky. A Ukrainian envoy last week said Manila has yet to respond to their multiple requests for the talk. The diplomat has since apologized for his statement. Marcos, meanwhile, says the Philippine government has already responded to the requests.
There was talk of it a couple of months ago, pero hindi na wala nang napag-usapan. So nagulat kami when the special envoy came out and said na hindi pa sinasagot. Sinagot namin, but we didn't get it scheduled. Couldn't get it scheduled. I have no problem with talking to President Zelensky, especially now that mainit ng gera dun sa kanila. So of course we are on the side of peace, and that remains the same. But any expressions of support that he might feel is needed, we are happy to provide it.
Over in Ukraine, hopes of finding more survivors are fading following a Russian missile strike on an apartment building. 30 people are confirmed dead in Saturday's attack on a 9-story building in Inipo City. 43 other individuals are missing. More than 70 people were wounded. Russia also hit other cities on Saturday, including the capital Kyiv and Kharkiv. Moscow acknowledged the missile strikes in a statement, but did not mention Dnipro as a specific target. Moscow has repeatedly denied targeting civilians in the war.